Your home is meant to be your safe space, somewhere where you can relax and feel at ease. It's where your family is, your pets, all your stuff, everything you care about centralized in one location. So when that location is taken and turned into something scary, a specific kind of fear is struck in your heart, especially when things take a turn that you weren't quite ready for. With that in mind, I'm Amy from What Culture, and here are 10 home invasion horror movies that broke all the rules. 10. Hush. Limited senses and heightened tension. Often a lot of the tension in a home invasion scenario comes from the sound. You would first realize that someone was breaking into your house if you heard your door being broken down or a window being smashed, for example. And then you go and wait in terror as you hear footsteps creeping closer to the closet you're inevitably going to hide in. This is where Hush takes a turn, as Maddie, the protagonist, is deaf and mute. After a visit from a buddy of hers one evening, she's visited by someone far less friendly, a masked killer. Living in the back end of nowhere, Maddie is definitely not in the prime position to get help when someone's trying to break in and murder her. With the added problem of not being able to hear her attacker moving around, there are some horribly tense moments that will leave you shouting at the screen for her to just turn around. Girl, he's right behind you! Trying to avoid giving too much away, there is one spoiler I'll give for this movie that subverts another expectation. Her beloved cat companion that we meet at the start, fortunately, he actually manages to survive. You know, if anything, you can rely on me to give you lists without any cat death. 9. Don't Breathe. We root for the intruders. It didn't take too long after its release for this film to become infamous. The clever move to invert the assumptions about the criminals and the homeowner impressed a lot of people, for once not painting the blind old man as being the victim. In this movie, we see three people break into the home of the old man, Nordstrom, hoping to hit the big bucks when they take the $300,000 cash they hear he keeps in there. After watching him for a bit, they learn that he's blind and wrongfully assume it's gonna be easy pickings. Just when they think they've got things all planned out, they find that Nordstrom is an absolute beast, and that there's more than just cash hidden in his basement. Suddenly, the tables are turned on the intruders, and it's not just the money they're fighting to escape with, but their lives too. This is another film where sound plays a huge role, but in the opposite way than with Hush. When the slightest noise could alert the psycho to the location of our protagonists, you better believe you'll be on the edge of your seat begging for silence. 8. I See You. Switching to the intruder's perspective. This film features a home invasion in an atypical sense, but the meaning of this isn't revealed until partway through when we have a full change of perspective. For the first chapter of the film, we follow the Harper family as strange things start happening in their house. Things are being moved and going missing. Items are even turning up that have links to missing persons cases. It's clear that someone is in the family house messing with them, and this takes a particularly sinister turn when someone turns up dead in the basement. But who's messing with them and why? The big twist halfway through the film turns all our assumptions on their heads as we rewind to when the strange happenings began and look through the eyes of two homeless young people doing what they call frogging, which really isn't as inappropriate as it sounds, it just means to live in someone else's house without them knowing. It's revealed that all the strange happenings have been caused by the duo, but furthermore, that in their time they've uncovered something that makes their crime of semi-home invasion pale in comparison. Essentially, it's a fun gimmick to switch the story halfway through, especially to use it to hit us with a double twist. 7. The People Under the Stairs. Cannibal children. There's a lot to unpack in this movie, as the entry header suggests. You wonder how we get from home invasion to cannibal children, but actually it's best that I don't spoil the exact journey for you. The setup for this film is that our protagonist Fool and his family are being unfairly evicted from their home by the greedy landlords, the Robersons. Fool and two friends break into the Robersons' house by getting one of them, Spencer, to pose as a municipal worker. But when Spencer fails to emerge from the house, Fool grows suspicious. The remaining two friends go looking for Spencer in the house, which proves to be a huge mistake, as they're met with Spencer's dead body and a group of pale, feral cannibal children. I won't spoil the rest of the movie from here, but it's safe to say that this wasn't the journey Fool expected to go on when breaking into his landlord's home. Never trust a landlord, that's what I say. 6. Intruders. The victims aren't really just victims. This starts off as just another typical break-in scenario. Anna, the homeowner, offers delivery man Dan a large sum of money after they grow close over the years, with him being a constant in her life as she cared for her sick brother before his death. Dan makes the mistake of telling his buddies about Anna's offer, which motivates them to break into her house and attempt to steal her cash. We feel pretty bad for Anna. Not only has her brother just died of cancer, but then three horrible men break into her home, kill her pet bird, and prevent her from going to her own brother's funeral. Girl's having a real tough week. Well, innocent little agoraphobic Anna isn't everything we thought she was. As she starts getting her own back on the intruders, various contraptions and monitoring systems around the house betray her darker nature. It's revealed that prior to his death, Anna's brother was a serial killer who murdered child molesters in the basement, including their own father. When you're faced with two different kinds of criminal, it makes it difficult to fully root for one of them, so this added moral dimension helps set this film apart from the rest. Although, you know, we're probably still gonna side more with the paedophile killer. 5. Wait Until Dark, a con man angle. It was tempting to say that this film's selling point was just Audrey Hepburn, but it does in fact have appeal beyond her appearance. Blind housewife Susie finds herself in an unfortunate situation after becoming entangled in a drug operation. She comes into possession of a heroin-stuffed doll, and three criminals turn up at her door intent on getting their hands on it. They first try to convince her that they're other people, trying to earn her trust and build a relationship to get her to hand it over. It's all going as planned until Susie's friend informs her that things aren't as they seem, and Susie realizes she has to outsmart the men playing this game with her. Light plays an important role in many of the fight scenes and Susie's plans, making for some interesting visuals and something unique in the realms of the intruder versus homeowner chase sequences. It's by far the oldest entry on this list, which in itself sets it apart from the others, and by virtue of being made that bit earlier than most popular home invasion horrors, it has an approach you may not have seen much of before. 4. The Purge, being part of something bigger. When the original Purge came out in 2013, people instantly became fascinated with the world it was set in. The idea of 12 hours of completely legal crime was super interesting to people, and the possibilities that came with it for some cool horror scenarios were definitely exciting. It's not often that an invasion is set as a part of a wider context, with most movies focusing on random acts of violence or money-motivated burglaries. In this film, we follow the Sandins, a wealthy family hoping to just wait out the purge in their heavily secured home. After bringing in a wounded homeless man, the family becomes the target of a masked gang, who, after the Sandins refuse to hand over the homeless man, begin an assault on the house. It has all the normal staples of a home invasion, but with the context of a nationwide crime spree in action. With this, it allows for some details and happenings that otherwise we don't really see or think of. 3. Better watch out. It's an inside job. I'll set the scene. It's Christmas time, the lights are lit, and it's frosty outside. An older teenager, Ashley, is babysitting an annoying 12-year-old kid, Luke. Luke tries to make moves on Ashley as they watch a horror movie, and she unsurprisingly isn't into it. So, with things as uncomfortable as they already are, it's a good thing that another annoying 12-year-old turns up to make everything worse in the shape of Luke's friend, Garrett. This already terrible babysitting job is imminently going to get worse, when some strange noises and happenings put the group on edge, culminating in Garrett fleeing the house and seemingly getting shot outside. As Luke and Ashley hide upstairs from the suspected gunman patrolling the house, Ashley figures out that something's wrong, soon enough unmasking the man to reveal it's been Garrett all along. The boys were hoping that they could scare Ashley into Luke's arms by staging a home invasion, but when that doesn't work out, they take it a step further. They tie Ashley up and attach her to a chair, thereby making her a victim of a brutal attack staged in part by one of the house's own occupants. It's safe to say that this subverts expectations in that you don't usually see a home invasion where the victim isn't a resident of the house, but the perpetrator is. 2. Funny Games, the meta element. Contrary to the happy title, nothing about Funny Games is fun, not a single moment. This is a particularly infamous horror movie in general, never mind its specific standing in the home invasion subgenre. It's known for its incredibly dark tone, crafted in part by its meta scripting and the occasional breaking of the fourth wall. When it came out, it broke all the rules of the traditional home invasion film because it called out the audience for watching. Knowing that so many movies of its kind were brutal and senselessly violent, Funny Games took all of this and showed it to the audience, asking why they wanted to watch such a thing in the first place. Which, when you think about how desensitized we all are to horrific things nowadays, is kind of a valid question. This is also one of the slightly rarer films where there is no happy resolution at the end. The bad guys win, and they win by quite a margin. They enter the home, torture the family, and then murder them all. Simple as that. It's a truly hopeless, exhausting movie that manages manages to break the rules by getting audiences to feel really bad about themselves. 1. The Collector. A home invasion inside a home invasion. Going from one type of meta to another, we now have the home invasion squared, whereby in this film a man goes to break into a home just to realize that somebody else has already beat him to it. One night, former convict turned handyman Arkin plans to break into his employer's home to steal a valuable gemstone. On arriving at the house and making it to the safe, however, he finds that somebody else is already in the house and terrorizing the family. The house is boarded up and rigged with traps to prevent escape, as a killer referred to as the Collector wreaks havoc. His MO is to kill all but one person in each household, the remaining survivor being his souvenir that he keeps locked in a trunk. You know, for souvenirs, you usually just take like a magnet or a keyring, I don't know. Well, where usually we have to decide whether the intruder or the homeowners are the bad guys, in this film at least there's a distinct third party that clearly takes the cake. And with that, we've reached the end of this list of 10 home invasion horror movies that broke all the rules. If you can think of any others you would have put on this list, then let us know in the comments below. And remember to check out whatculture.com for more lists and articles like this every single day. As always, I've been Amy from What Culture, and I'll catch you next time.